What is good, everybody? It is your boy Batman, and this is not going to be too long of a video. And actually, hold on, I'm already fucking up. Okay, it's actually not Batman. It is, but this channel is Batruto, ladies and gentlemen. And this channel is going to be consisting mainly of reaction videos. It can be anything, music videos, try not to laugh, anything you can think of. It will be strictly for reaction, and also towards two passions that I have, Naruto or Batman. Okay, maybe even like Marvel as well and things like that. But overall, like, it's mainly a reaction-focused channel, and also to post things that I would not feel too comfortable to post to my main channel, just in case, you know, for BS, YouTube reasons, so on and so forth, copyright, etc., the whole nine yards, you name it. But yeah, this is going to be mainly for reactions, so on and so forth. I really, really hope to God I don't have all tons of issues, blah, blah. I would do my very best to transform these videos, make them creative, react. There would be a decent amount of pause moments to avoid copyright, etc., and this and that, you know. But other than that, you know, that's basically going to be it. Now, for this first video, you're not going to be able to see my face. I'm going to try to show my face as much as possible whenever I do these types of videos, but not for this one. And a second reason, this is actually more of a serious song. It has a serious tone to it, so it's not really a song like to get kind of hyped to, you know, or blah blah this and that, yada yada. It's a song more of like elaborating on understanding and taking it seriously and understanding that there is importance to this song as well. It's very tragic, it's very sad, and it's very serious. So have I listened to it already? I'm not gonna lie to you, I have listened to it twice already. So this has been my third time, but I really wanted to play this song and share it with you guys and give my thoughts on it at least. And then every other video will be first time, like, blind, like, you know, pure reactions. So, this is going to be our first video on the start of this channel. We got 15 minutes, so we ain't going to fuck around. Let's get it, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
I was walking home on a Sunday. I was walking home on a Sunday.
Okay, Dax.
I was walking home on a Sunday.
Pay attention to what he keeps repeating, by the way. That's actually important. And you guys are probably like, huh? Like, why is it actually important? It actually really, really is important. And not only that, I'm actually going to show my face. Fuck it. I'm going to show my face because I really, really don't want to have copyright. I can't stand it. Copyright is so aggravating, to be honest. But let me get my face cam set up and you guys get to see my ugly face. Okay. So I'm going to keep it at this size. I'm not going to make it too big, but you guys can at least see my face. My big ass forehead too. And we're going to get it. Let's get it. 50 minutes.
I was walking home on a Sunday.
Oh, I love that. Beat's really nice too.
But I'm not looking forward to anything in my life because it never liked me. I can't sleep because I don't know what's inside.
Ooh.
Me. The devil's demons haunting dude.
Yeah.
And I think I'm over.
Yep. Let him know, Dax.
Stop walking. If I told you a story that you wouldn't believe, not sure I should feel a sigh of relief. Yeah, damn, but he didn't get
I love the words that he fucking does. You know, like, if I told you a story that you wouldn't believe, it wouldn't even give me a sign of relief. You know, like, so on and so forth. Except, like, God, I love how he connects the words. I love the meanings behind it and the correlations. It's beautiful and it's incredible. Man, I just fucking love it. And another thing too, if you guys can't tell by the fucking title of the song, this is basically based about PTSD. If you guys don't know what PTSD, you know, post-traumatic stress disorder, you know, it's a big, big deal. You know, a lot of military veterans have it, so on and so forth, or any just traumatic experiences, etc. I'd be a liar if I didn't actually have a PTSD myself from what I've been through in my life. So it's a big deal. It's a very serious topic. It's very sad and depressing as well, and a lot of people fight on a daily basis to get past it, you know, and to be stronger and etc., or better yet, to this day are still fighting it or have to fight it for the rest of their life. It depends on the version of it and the extreme and etc. And what he's doing is, not only is he talking about the importance and the tragedy and the concept of PTSD, but he's also telling a story. So we're gonna really focus on the words and really listen, and it's a very, very serious, dark, sad story. Very serious. So, and we will go over and we'll pause and etc.
Some odd reason I don't feel free. So now what? This pain is too much. The screams of the people make music.
I want to really listen to this, you know?
It's too tough, so I must wipe my mind of everything on that church. Suppress all these feelings even though that they hurt. I don't understand how you could let this happen. God, I want to know why you would even let that man on.
Oh my God, I love that part, bro. Like, you guys are probably like, huh? Like, what? You know, like, oh my God, I love that part, bro. That scream, bro, that fucking emotion and passion. Hell yes. Give me that. I love it when music delivers that shit, bro. When he literally, like, asks God, and he's like, why in God's name did you let that man, and blah, blah, etc. Like, I don't know the exact lyrics towards, like, the end of it, but all I do know is he's addressing to God and asking him a question and refers to the man. And just, so I know that at least. And when you hear the rest of the song, then you'll see why it makes sense. I love that, though. Beautiful. Rewind that.
At church, suppress all these feelings even though that they hurt. I don't understand how you could let this happen.
See?
God, I want to know why you would even let that
man on. I think he said why you would even let that man on in. I think that's what he says.
Believe that this life is by you and whatever you choose is the best.
Deep.
I'm just human, I don't understand you. I know you are
same.
Very complex. What should I go do next? My thoughts cannot connect. My PTSD shakes me and leaves me depressed.
So right there, that's actually some pretty important bars that he just said, by the way, guys. Fucking, like, literally what he just said. And remind you, I'm a Christian myself. I hope that doesn't piss anyone off. I do believe in God, okay? I have my own, you know, beliefs, you know, and I do believe in God and blah, blah, and this and that. But I'm not like, you know, that typical, you know, stereotype Christian that either doesn't curse or this or that, or yada, yada, etc. Like, there's different versions of Christians. You have NF that basically won't curse to save his life, but he'll still talk about certain things that technically you wouldn't talk about as a Christian. And then Dax, he's kind of similar to me, kind of, you know, talks about all kinds of stuff, etc., that you technically wouldn't want to do as a Christian. You know, technically, if we're going by the book, that reminds you has tons of contradictions and etc. And I'll probably trigger and piss off a lot of people that read the Bible and a Christian, but whatever. I'm sitting right now, I don't give a fuck, okay? So, overall, you know, he's similar to me. He does curse, this and that, etc. But at the end of the day, if I have to really give an honest answer, I'm not going to lie, I do believe there is a God. So, and that's basically it. Other people, I can understand in all kinds of measures, degrees, forms, in millions of fucking separate multiverses of why they do not even believe in God, and it does make sense, because at the end of the day, this song right here is a prime example of, like, wow, if God's really fucking out there, the fact that this shit happened, what the fuck, you know? So, but overall, okay, you know, that's just me, so, but I won't really agree with that, and I strongly, strongly disagree with the fact that, like, I will never, ever, like, if God was in front of me, okay, and literally, I just went through the most fucking traumatic experience of my life. Some crazy, insane, dark, like, scarring type level crap in my life. Okay? And I was in front of God and realized he's real. I would be furious. I would be angry and I would be hurting and in so much pain. Because the fact that he can create life, regardless of the free will, you know, reason, or he loves us so much, or he can't interfere, maybe for some reason, whatever. Regardless of whatever reason we try to give, based either from the Bible, Christians, whatever. At the end of the day, there is no excuse. Morally, there is no goddamn excuse. There is no justification, and there is no, like, moral, like, fucking, like, comprehension of why it's okay for innocent people or kids to go through horrible, disgusting things in life. Whether if it's trauma, tragedies, you name it. I can say all of it. We all know, okay? We've all seen it, heard it, everything. Okay? And you maybe, if you are even watching this video, you more than likely have been through it as well. So overall, like, it's sad. It's really, really sad. That's all I will say. I'm really trying to hit the 15-minute mark. I don't want to be too long, but I just want to say that at least. Well, let's continue.
In the back of my mind, there's a place that I know full of sorrow.
Nice.
when I think of those times, my anxiety feels what is hard.
I can relate.
I don't know when it'll go away, but I hope it'll
me
go
too.
Away. I just pray I feel better when I sleep and wake
always,
up.
Always, but I don't. Not all the time.
Here we go.
This is my favorite part of the song, by the way. This is when he tells the story of his PTSD. Just listen to the words. It's insane. Absolutely insane. And also, remember when I said in the beginning, listen, like left foot, right foot, or I'm walking on to church on a Sunday, blah, blah, this and that. Really pay attention to that, and I'll elaborate what he means by that. But this part, just remember it.
Wake up tomorrow.
Foot, right foot, keep walking. Left foot, right foot, keep walking.
Don't look back, your past is haunting. Demons creeping, always stalking. In that church, I got down crawling. Could not stop my eyes from falling. Children screaming, bodies falling. Keeps on shooting, bullets hawking. Someone help us, please just stop him. Why is he laughing? He's been plotting. Says get up, I hear death calling. I stood up and started walking. We locked eyes and he was smiling. Shot himself, I saw him dying.
I'll be honest with you guys. If you actually really listened and paid attention, and I'm going to replay it, and I'm going to go over the parts piece by piece. If I ever had to witness something like that, or mind you, I've witnessed some really, really bad things in my life. But if I ever, to even that extreme, I don't even know. I really don't know. I don't even know how that would, I probably wouldn't even be the same person that I am to this day. Like, just horrible, sad, so fucking tragic. And then you wonder why people don't believe in God. Or better yet, when Dax or other Christians are over here saying, you know, like, what the fuck, God? You know, like, why? You know, like, I just don't understand you and this and that and yada yada. Like, we're going to listen one more time.
On shooting. Keep walking, left foot, right foot, keep walking. Don't look back, your past
but
is
don't
haunting.
Don't look back, your past is haunting.
Demons creeping, always stalking.
Demons creeping, always stalking.
In that church, I got down crawling.
In that church, I got down crawling. Crawling, so he's crawling. He got down, he's starting to crawl.
Could not stop my eyes from bawling,
meaning he's crying, you know, furiously. He's crawling, he's trying to get away, and he's crying, he's freaking out, he's panicking.
Children screaming, bodies falling,
meaning people are, children, adults are screaming, you know, yada yada, bodies are falling.
Keeps on shooting,
meaning it's a mass shooter at a church. And if you guys don't know, like, this song could be, I don't know, like, the full backstory, but this song could easily be portrayed to anything, you know, from either the mass shootings in churches, you know, with black people, or just in general, or overall just mass shooting, period. So, and it's a very, very tragic thing. I'm not going to really get into that whole thing. I'll save that for another video, because Eminem actually has a song towards mass shooting. And I think it was just an incredible video, an incredible song overall, narratively, and etc. But if you guys just, mind you, I just repeated it and paused it, like, yeah, it's fucked.
Bullets hawking, someone help us, please just stop
someone
him.
Someone just help us, please just stop him. That's just a logical response. If you have no measures of self-defense, hand-to-hand combat training, or military training, or etc., or if there's not even a cop, or someone to be there to protect you, and you are completely defenseless, and a person has a fucking AR rifle, and he's just mowing people down in a church, and you can't escape because there's only one way to get out, you know, or maybe if there is an exit, but if you get up, he'll just shoot you and kill you. You're literally defenseless, and you're literally at that person's mercy. That is the most terrifying experience to ever go through, because you literally could die at any moment. And are hearing people die and die in front of you and seeing it, blood and all of it. Just horrible. Horrible.
Why is he laughing? He's been
plotting. Why is he laughing? He's been plotting. And while he's killing all these kids, people, etc., he's laughing. And he's like, he must be plotting.
He says,
get up, I hear death calling. Meaning the guy shouted at him because he knew he was behind the chair and crawling, crying, and said, get up. And he's like, I hear death calling, meaning like he thinks he's going to die now.
I stood up and started walking. We locked eyes and he was smiling. Shot himself, I saw him.
So literally what he just said right there is he started walking towards him. And then the guy stared at him and exchanged glances. He smiled and then shot himself. And then he was dying in front of him. So literally in a nutshell, guys, this guy came in there, started shooting kids and adults and etc., all kinds of ages probably, killing people. He's crawling on the floor, crying, panicking, hearing the screams, bodies falling, blood, you name it, the whole nine yards. And then the guy knows he's there, yells at him to get up. He forces him to walk up to him, basically at his mercy, terrified to his fucking bone, okay? And literally then smiles at him, smiles after doing all of that. Or better yet, he laughed first, then told him to stand up, then told him to call, like basically like torturing him to a certain measure and degree, and then smiles and then shoots himself and kills himself, and he's dying in front of him. Imagine going through all of that and witnessing that. Imagine yourself being in that situation. And for anyone that has or something similar, I am gratefully, like not even great, what the, I really am so sorry you had to go through that, because I don't even know what I would do myself. PTSD is nothing to joke around about. It's very serious. And for anyone that has any form or measure of it, I will pray for you. I wish the best for you. And you are strong and you can do this. And even when you're not strong, even when you're weak and losing and etc., you have every right to. And don't look at that as a form of weakness or wrong or whatever. You have every right to feel what you're feeling. Because if God won't heal you, and if he wasn't even there to protect you and stop it, what's to say of why you can't cry or basically have mental health issues and fucking trauma, or basically to the point where you can't sleep, this, that, X, Y, and Z, domino effect to the point where literally now your life is basically either ruined forever, momentarily, or permanently, or temporarily, not permanently. So I'm just going to put that, I'm going to rewind it one more time so you guys can actually hear it for one last time, and then we'll finish the song.
Always stalking in that church, I got down crawling. Could not stop my eyes from bawling. Children screaming, bodies falling. Keeps on shooting, bullets hawking. Someone help us, please just stop him. Why is he laughing? He's been plotting. Says get up, I hear death calling. I stood up and started walking. We locked eyes and he was smiling. Shot himself, I saw him dying. Adrenaline was in my system, I couldn't stop, I had to go. But I just knew that if I made it, I get out of praise alone. Now I'm walking on the cement, and I just hope I make it
home. Right there, he just said it. He's walking on the cement, and he hopes that he makes it home. So literally what he means, he just went through all of that, and is so traumatized, is so, like, zoned out, like, so out of it. Like, he's, like, gone. Probably has blood all over him, everything, you name it. And he starts to walk home. He starts to walk home. That's why when you hear in the beginning of the song, I went to a church on a Sunday, you know, and kept saying over and over, he's referring to when he went to the church on a Sunday. And then when he says left foot, right foot, keep walking, meaning that keep walking, just go home. And I'm going to tell you guys right now, once again, if that, I just, the saddest thing about it too is, you know, obviously I don't know if it's based on a true story or whatever, yada, yada, like, or what this even clearly is even referring to exactly, but imagine, like, you know, if he had family there, if, or, you know, or if his best friends were there or this or that, you know, because whenever I did go to church in the past, I had family members. I had people that were there with me in service. So literally imagine even losing all of your loved ones. Like, it's just horrible. horrible.
I was walking home on a Sunday. I was walking home on a Sunday. I was walking home on a Sunday. I was walking home on a Sunday.
10 out of 10, Dex. 10 out of 10. 10 out of goddamn 10, baby. No. No. Stop playing music. 10 out of 10, though. Hell, I'm like, that's just 10 out of 10. I will always rate everything I do reaction wise out of 10. 10 out of 10. He delivered the message, the song, the beat, everything, the words. It was all fucking perfect. Okay. The concept of it obviously isn't, and it's horrible and it's a tragedy itself, but the song, he definitely delivered. 10 out of 10. And that will basically be my thoughts on that for now. And if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, comment your thoughts down below, subscribe for more content, subscribe if you guys love this channel. This is a brand new channel. If it didn't hit the 15 mark, or if I don't have a way to make it to 15 mark somehow, then I'm just going to post it on my main channel for now. But I will start posting small, short videos on this channel. I will do it. I'll figure it out one way or another. This way I have the ability to post longer videos. So, Batman out. Bye.